Hey guys, so I just watched a video from Alice, one of my besties here on YouTube. I'm going to link her video in the description box below, where she swatched all of her concealers and foundations, and I couldn't be fast enough to steal her video idea, so here I am, going to do the exact same thing because I thought it was so interesting to see. I am going to swatch everything just on, whoopsie, just here on my hand, because today is sort of like my skincare day and I don't really feel like applying foundation or even like swatching foundation on my face. I also want to preface this by saying that I still don't know exactly what my undertones are. I always thought that I was like a neutral to yellow tone because when I tan, I become very yellow. People have told me that I have olive undertones, like some of you have told me that I have olive undertones, and that may be the case, I'm not sure. If I have olive undertones, they are for sure not very pronounced, and to be honest, I would rather not have olive undertones because those seem to be the least well represented in foundation ranges. So, enough said, let's just jump right into the swatching. I'm going to start with my foundations, and we're just going to go through the foundations, maybe a little bit in the ones that I use the most often, and then we're going to go into the ones that I use the least often. But these are basically all of my foundations, you guys. I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, I have 7 foundations. These are the 3 foundations that I enjoy the most on the daily. Let's start with my favorite one, which is the Estée Lauder Double Wear Nude Foundation. This is like the Double Wear line from Estee Lauder has always been my favorite. I've had the original one, I've also had the light version, the one that was reformulated, and as of recently, this is the one that I'm the biggest fan of. Now, I hate that this foundation doesn't come with a pump because it is just very difficult to control the amounts that come out of it. This foundation, I think, is also a pretty good match for me. Oh, I forgot to tell you, this is the shade 2N1. So I think this is a pretty good shade match for me. It leans neutral, so it's not too pink and it's not too yellow, which is maybe why it is not the absolute perfect match for me, because I feel like I lean a little bit more warm than neutral. But it is a relatively good match for me, and I really, really like the finish of this foundation. It is a very lightweight and sheer formula, and it has a bit of like a luminous finish to it. And by luminous, I don't mean greasy, I just mean like a natural luminous finish. It's really, really nice. The second foundation that I've been using very frequently lately is my Pat Morat Labs Skin Fetish Sublime Perfection Foundation. Mine is in the shade Light 5. I bought this foundation immediately upon release without seeing any swatches, without comparing myself to anyone who has similar skin tone to mine or undertones to mine, which is why I shade matched myself wrong, because this foundation is definitely too light for me. Let me quickly show you. It does have a very nice formula to it. It's once again one of those more sheer foundations. Well, you can immediately tell that this is quite much lighter compared to the one from Estee Lauder, which is why the one from Estee fits me a little bit better. When I'm at my very palest in the deep winter, I can pull this shade off, but I actually prefer to mix it with another one of the foundations that I'm going to show you later. I really like the finish of this foundation. It's a very sheer, light coverage with a very natural finish. It's not a luminous finish, it's not a dewy finish, it's definitely a natural finish, and it is a very beautiful formula, but I'm gonna be completely honest with you, throughout the day I think the Double Wear foundations still perform better on me than the one from Pat. The one from Pat, after like 6-7 hours, tends to break up a little bit on me, whereas the Estee Lauder Double Wear never really does that. So while I really like the finish and I really like how it looks on the face upon first application, I think the one from Estee still performs better on the long run. This next foundation I haven't actually used since the summer of last year, and the reason for that being it is a little bit too dark for me. This is the Dior Backstage foundation. Mine is in the shade 2N, which theoretically should be my shade, but in practice it is actually just a tad too dark for me. I love this foundation in terms of formula because it is, once again, a very sheer, very natural looking formula. You can see that this foundation actually has a very similar undertone to the one from Estee Lauder, but it's just a little bit deeper and a little bit peachier. And it is also a little bit darker on me if I would apply it in the deepest winter, which is why I prefer to use it in the summer, because then it matches me really, really well. These two foundations also have a very similar formula. They are both very natural on the skin. They perform really well throughout the day. The difference is this one is more of a demi matte finish. So when I apply this on my skin, it looks a little bit less luminous than the one from Estee Lauder, which is why I think I slightly prefer the one from Estee Lauder. But I haven't used this one in a while, so I will have to like use them again against each other to really tell whether I prefer one more over the other. But I really, really like the Dior Backstage as well. I was completely obsessed with this foundation the year that I was pregnant, because the year that I was pregnant I had hay fever, and for the first time and only time in my life I also had like this beautiful like eczema splotches all over my face. It was dreadful. For like a whole month or two I just couldn't really apply any of my normal foundations because they looked awful on me, and that is when I discovered the Face and Body Foundation from MAC. I believe they have recently like expanded the line, or something happened with this foundation. This is probably one of the sheerest foundations that I have in my collection, and one of the foundations that is the most forgiving if you have any sort of texture on your skin, which is what I had in 2018 in the summer when I was looking for something to have at least somewhat of a coverage on my face. This is, by the way, the shade C3, which is also a little bit too deep for me, but like I said, I bought this in the summertime to use in the summertime, and I never really purchased the shade C2, which would be my winter foundation, because for whatever reason in the winter I prefer to use more full coverage foundations. So very interestingly, you can see that this foundation is leaning quite a bit more yellow compared to these other foundations. The one from Pat is very light and it still has those like light peach tones to it. These two are definitely more on like the neutral peachy side, and this one is yellow. It's like yellow, which is probably why it works so well for me in the summer when I'm a bit more tan, because I tan, like I said, quite yellow. It is the most sheer of the four, but I also think that's one of its strengths, because in the summer when it's really hot, you don't want to apply something with too much coverage on your face that will melt off. You want something that will just slightly correct your skin tone, but still won't, you know, melt off your face, and that is what the Face and Body will do for you. So if you really enjoy very, very sheer coverage foundations, like barely there foundations, you are really going to enjoy this Face and Body from MAC. Now let's talk about my Hourglass foundations. I have the Hourglass Vanish Stick Foundation here in the shade Buff. I really, really tried to like this foundation. I think in terms of its color, it is a pretty good match for me. You can see again it leans a little bit more yellow compared to these three foundations, but when I put it on my face, it looks pretty okay. So it's more comparable to the Face and Body Foundation from MAC. It is, of course, a cream foundation, a stick foundation, so it has a completely different formula, and that is what I really don't like about this foundation. I just can never quite figure out what tool to use to apply this foundation so that it doesn't cling on to dry patches on my face that I didn't even know that I had. So some days I will apply it over like a very dewy primer, or better say a dewy moisturizer, because I don't really use primers anymore. I use my moisturizers as primers, and then it will look decent, and then there will be other days when it will cling on to dry patches, like I said, that I didn't even know I had. So it's a very like inconsistent foundation for me. I recently started using it together with this brush, this Koyudo Fupa brush, and it seems to work really well that way, but it's not my favorite foundation, and it's not one that I tend to reach for a lot, because it also tends to break up sometimes during the day. Like, some days it will look flawless in the end of the day, and some days it will look awful. And I can never really quite tell what kind of, like, whimsical step in my routine makes this foundation break up or not break up, which is why I don't find it to be a reliable foundation, which is why I only tend to use it when I know that I'm not going to be wearing foundation for, like, a full day. I also have another Hourglass foundation. This is the Vanish Seamless Liquid Foundation. I was going through a phase a couple of years ago when I had just discovered the Hourglass finishing powders, and because the finishing powders worked so well for me, I thought the foundations would as well. I was basically just trying to make fetch happen because I didn't really like the stick foundation, and this one is so incredibly full coverage that I don't really use that kind of like finish anymore on my face. I have to mix this foundation with other things in order to make it work, and also it's very difficult to estimate how much you need to use from this foundation in order for it not to look cakey on your face. By the way, this is the same shade as the one from the stick, which is the shade Buff. This is one of the thickest, most full coverage foundations that I have in my collection. Like, this amount could cover my whole face. I shit you not. In terms of undertone, it is actually quite similar to the stick foundation. I think they are pretty much the same color. Actually, because this foundation is so full coverage and because the one from Pat McGrath is so incredibly light in tone, I actually tend to mix these two together, like the smallest bit of the Hourglass foundation with a pump of the Pat McGrath foundation, and that tends to kind of give you the best of both worlds because it corrects the undertone of this one to match me better and it makes this one usable for me. And last but certainly not least, we have the original Estée Lauder Double Wear foundation. This one is in the shade 3-in-1 Ivory Beige. I actually did not purchase this myself. This was gifted to me by one of my friends from work who said that this wasn't a good match for her. And I took it over because I thought it might match me really well in the summer, and I really enjoy the formula of the Estée Lauder Double Wear line. Oh, this is not working. Why is it? She even bought a pump for it and the fucking pump won't work. Okay, let me just... So as you can see, this also leans more yellow, which is why it works well for me in the summer months. And it is like a step darker than the two from Hourglass. And I think that's, you know, in terms of tone, this foundation works really well for me because it has the right undertone. It's just too dark for me to wear. So these are all the foundations that I currently have in my collection. I don't know if any of them are really a perfect match for me, but I use them, I like them, I can kind of make them work without looking completely ridiculous. Alright you guys, let's quickly swatch my concealers. I only have four, and actually two of them are just the same brand but a different color. Let's start with my Oldie But Goodie, my favorite for the longest amount of time. Again, I should preface this by saying I have extremely dry skin underneath my eyes and I have an extremely hard time finding concealers that don't just like suck the moisture out of my skin in a matter of seconds. So this is the one that I have relied on for years and years and years when I couldn't really find anything that worked for me. I have found other things now that work for me, but for the longest time this was my trusty. This is the Skin Food Salmon Dark Circle Concealer Cream in the shade, I want to say this is the shade 1. They also have 2. This is a very creamy pot concealer with a very strong peach tone to it. It's a very nice concealer if you don't like more like rich, oily feeling concealers. Maybe you won't like this one, but I remember a few years ago this concealer was all the rage among like beauty makeup bloggers. I don't even think it was vloggers, I think it was bloggers. It was like back in my blogging time that I discovered this concealer, and I actually still quite like it. This is the, I think, the third pot that I have in my collection, and the only reason that I branched out is because I kind of got bored with it and I wanted to try something different that doesn't come in a pot. So I still really enjoy this concealer. It works for me all year round except for when I'm really really tan, and I highly recommend it if you struggle to find, you know, concealers that are not too drying for under your eyes. The next concealer is one that I discovered a couple of years ago. It's the Clarins Instant Concealer in the shade 01. This is a really good concealer because it has a very decent coverage, but it's not too full coverage. I also, by the way, do not like concealers that are too full coverage. I need something that just lightly corrects under my eyes and gives them a bit more like liveliness and the feeling that I look awake. I don't want anything more from a concealer. I don't have dark like circles under my eyes that I need to conceal, so for me finding a concealer in that aspect is not that hard. This is a very good match for me. It's a very nice like neutral leaning concealer. You can tell that it's much less peachy compared to the one from Skin Food, and it has a very pleasant, very natural finish to it. It's not a luminous finish, but it is also not a dry matte finish. It has a beautiful natural finish to it. And last but not least, I bought these two concealers as per recommendation of my very good friend Melissa here on YouTube, Melissa Gold, whom I'm sure you're familiar with. She recommended the First Aid Beauty Hello Fab Bendy Avocado Concealer in one of her videos, and because she has also struggled with dry skin under her eyes, as soon as I heard that she enjoys this concealer, I was like, I need to try this yesterday. So I did purchase originally the shade 3, which is considered to be the shade, I want to say this is the shade light. There was something about the shade range of this concealer that threw me off, because I bought the shade light, I think this is the shade light, and then I thought, oh, this is actually quite dark for my under eyes. I think it will work really well in the summer months when I have a bit more tan, but in the winter it is just, you can tell, it's quite dark. It works well as like a foundation color, but absolutely not as a concealer color. It leans a little bit more yellow, these two are a little bit more peachy, this leans a little bit more yellow, but I think that would work great for me if I have a little bit of a tan. So for the time being, the shade 3 is kind of like chilling in my drawer waiting for me to get a tan, and what I am using is the shade number 2, which is Fair. I've never been fair in anything, but apparently I'm fair in the concealer range of First Aid Beauty. This is in fact a beautiful formula. Melissa did not steer me wrong. This is a perfect actually shade match for me in concealer, because it really like lightens and lifts my under eyes, and it gives me exactly the effect that I want, and it has a beautiful creamy non-drying formula to it. And here you guys once again are all of my concealers. I think my favorite one would be the First Aid Beauty, then the one from Clarins, and finally the one from Skinfood. And the one from Skinfood I'm rating last, not for any other reason, but because I've used it for so many years that I'm just tired, plain tired of it. Not because it has a bad formula, it's actually a really really good concealer. So guys, that was all for this video. I hope this was enjoyable, useful and interesting to you. I certainly thought it was very interesting for me to see all of my concealers and foundations swatched next to each other. Thanks for hanging out with me, and I'll see you in my next video. Bye!